Hi everybody, welcome to Farming Simulator 2013. I'm starting a brand new career. I'm going to select normal and we're going to go to the Spring Hills Farm, the 2013 edition. It'll be the first time that I've really played this farm seriously. I've had it up for a while, as well as the default farm, just learning the ropes and getting myself organized, but here we are at the farmhouse. Let's go for a bit of a run here. So it looks like we have a grain field that is ready to harvest down there. And here's the main farm. So there's two pits. Silos over here. Yeah, it's loading there. Grain and fertilizer here. Some machinery there. That must be potato and beet there. And there's a gate into that field. This is the stock unit that looks like it's the slurry tank type. Dung heap. Mess tuck unit, feeding area. Milking parlor there. There's a weedy man and it's for fuel. Maybe some machinery here. Okay. So, nice little farm. Kind of reminiscent of home, I have to say. So, I'm going to yoke up this this trailer. And then what we're going to do is we're going to bring it into this field. Now I know that there's a second exit, or a second gate up here. So I'm going to make use of that. We're going to go into the field quite a bit here actually. And into a stock. Then we're going to actually set a course play. One egg. Two eggs. And then bring her into here. Stop that and reset the course. I'm going to do it again. Because that wasn't very good. So stop here. Start. Just wait for the two egg to blue. That's the first one. That's the second one. Now we'll try and make this into a little meter. Yeah, the wagon wheels will get to there and then I should be able to just bring her in to there. See, that's not going to work either. There is a way to edit the course. Which I can't remember how to do it. I think you pause. You delete last. to be cast. Yeah, that's how you do it. Show all, and then you continue recording. You now go back to wherever your last point was. And we can take any route you like there. But that is actually the last point, so delete last, delete last, delete last, delete last. Oh, there's a Midlory coming down. Nice to see that the Midlory is in the game. I like the Midlory man in real life. This was the last point here. So now if I continue recording from here, it's a bit busy, but maybe I'm okay. Now it should register the onload point there. Just a case of getting it all the way up and back in the gears. And we go fairly close to here because that's good, and then we will stop recording there. Now, there's a few little conditions that I want to set. I want to increase that to 90%. I want to set the field speed down a little bit. There's no need for it to be that high, and I certainly don't want it to be driving at 31 miles an hour anywhere. As smooth and smooth as fast, so I'm getting 10 or 12 on that. Yeah. So I'm going to save that. Now, what was this field number again? I think it was field 14. So F14. To silo. Okay, done. Now let's see what he does when he drives the course. Yellow and blue, I think, is my condition. That's cool. That's pretty cool. Okay. But, well, maybe that's kind of the targeting system that the program uses. So. Basically keeps the blue dot between the yellow dots, but it has, you know, a degree of flexibility there. Not so sure why it's doing all those circles, but it's not having any difficulty there. Okay, so next thing to do is find the combine. connect the head and see if we can reverse her out. Grand job. This is at the sheep farm. Okay, we're going to deny that, and I wish there was a way. I haven't learned how yet to just set this off completely and have it fixed. Don't want those missions. I have enough to do. Well, it's 7:30 and the cock is still crowing, which is decent. The one we had at home couldn't tell time. Well, that's a cock that's ready for, so ready for harvest as well. And I don't think I own that field. In fact, I'm pretty sure I don't. But I think I'm still going to harvest it. Although my quick run through, I don't recall having harvesting equipment for maize. There are a few changes that I'm going to make to my equipment. I'm going to sell quite a bit of the expensive stuff that I have, and buy cheaper stuff. There's a couple of mods that are out from FSUK, from NI Modding, which this map is from, and a few other folks here and there, which are really cool mods because they're stuff from the mid 80s and the early 90s. NI Modding have some Ford 7000s, Ford 4000s, which are sweet. They're really nice, muchy likey. And FSUK have some mid 90s Fords. I can't remember their series right now. I think they're kind of 5800 series. And I'm going to try and go up here to the right. But they're really well done, and I'm giving them a lot of consideration. This is an old FAR, which this 14-foot header is going to be fairly tight here. Given that the header is outside the wheels, if I can get the header through, I'm good. Okay. I think we just cut straight into this now. Just go back into the course play here, and I'm going to change the mode if I can. And I don't think I can. Stop driver, change mode to combine, empty and offload. That means I need to set the combine to automatic find, which is good. Yeah, I think we're good. So the drive course. And he's going straight onto that now. Okay, well, we'll leave him to do that away. And we can carry on. I'll have to do a few headlines here and a few things, but there's a limitation within the game in that they're going to drive over the top anyway and toss it down, but hey, it is what it is. He should sit there and wait until I get to 90%. And then he should come after me. Wheat by the looks of it. Um, 32% gives me 43,500, so there's 1,500 units of capacity here. So it's not a very big combine this far. So I'll be recording kind of pretty much everything that I'm doing here, and you're welcome to watch it if you like, although I can appreciate that you may choose to skip through sections of it and fast forward here and there. It's fine too. I won't be doing an awful lot of editing. The course play is pretty cool, and I hope that what I've done works. I guess we'll find out soon enough. Reflections on the water, huh? I'm just kind of going to cut out most of the section here. I'm sitting up quite a bit in the field actually, haven't I? But that's okay. The reason I set him up fairly deep in the field is the course play AI tend to have a random action when they're resetting to their start position. Sometimes they'll decide to make a turn and they could turn into a tree or turn into a wall or something. They don't seem to be too aware of their surroundings in that respect. So by setting them up pretty deep in there, there's no likelihood of them, you know, hitting a tree at least in there, because there aren't any. The problem with that, of course, is that they're in the middle of the crop, and that's not necessarily so realistic. But mind your heads, lads. See what I mean? I did hit the 99% there, so that's why he did that. Now I'm gonna have to go and rescue him. Yeah. So we'll stop the driver and see if we can reverse out of this in one piece.
already done.
Okay, so
maybe we can offload here anyway. Yeah. I don't know how you're going to correct for that now. Just make sure that I don't reach the 90% anywhere near there. And we should be alright, he says. I'll have to come back down here anyway, but damn it. It doesn't help when Bob, the hired hand, is dropped into the river. Looks like he's waiting there now anyway, so until I reach 90% again. So what I'll do is I will ask you to mind your heads, and what I'll do is I'll try and set up the 90% not to occur near the river.